So hello, today we're going to discuss about Gregor-Muller counter. So the Gregor-Muller counter is an instrument which is used for the measuring ionization radiation that is mainly caused by the alpha and beta particle for this instrument. So there is alpha and beta particle, and if we go to the construction of this instrument, it contains a cylindrical structure. So in between the cylindrical structure, if we see clearly, there is a thin filament. So there is a thin filament which is anode. So the thin filament is made to be anode, which is a positive. So here is anode is positive, that is. So and the body of the cylinder, so this whole body of the cylinder is cathode. Thin filament is anode and the body is a cathode, that is negative, and is connected through a battery and a resistor, and across this there is a amplifier. This is the amplifier. I'm going to talk about the function of the amplifier later. So inside the chamber, inside the Gregor-Muller chamber, there is argon and hydrocarbon compounds. There is argon and hydrocarbon compounds inside this Gregor-Muller counter chamber. Now what happens that alpha and beta particles strikes the gaseous ion inside this chamber, and it causes its ionization to form the cation and a negative electron. So this electron again excites other, and this causes a chain like reaction which causes the ionization of other gaseous ions also, and ultimately this huge amount of electron strikes the positive anode. And during this ionization, UV radiation is also liberated, which causes ionization of other gaseous ion also. And ultimately, this is a chain-like process happens in every direction inside this chamber. So the main principle of the Gregor-Muller chamber is the ionization of gaseous ion present inside the chamber. And this is the main working principle. So if we zoom this process, I have already drawn it here. That is, the upper is the red color written, that is the negative cathode, and below it, that is the positive anode filament. And when the incoming radiations of the alpha and beta particle strikes this gaseous ion, it liberates one electron and one cation, and this is called the first ionization process. So this first ionization process is denoted by this 1 degree symbol. So after the primary ionization, the liberation of one cation and one electron happens. So this cation being positive goes to the negative cathode, because positive is attracts negative. So this cation goes to the negative cathode of the wall of the cylinder, and the negative electron goes to the filament, that is positive anode, because positive is attracted by negative. So this chain of reaction which causes the excitation of electron from one to another, though this ionization increases huge in number, and which causes the liberation of many electrons at the end. So this many electrons after ionization at the end reaches this positive anode filament because they are negative, and this causes a change in this potential which is generated by this amplifier. So when a huge number of electrons after all this ionization process reaches this positive filament, because they are negative in nature, so the negative and positive interaction occurs, which causes a change in the potential value. So this voltage potential changes across this amplifier. So this change in potential causes a sudden drop in potential value, and which is detected by this amplifier. So what happens that due to these electrons, huge number of electrons going from the from their position towards the anode and interacting with this anode filament causes a sudden drop in the potential value. So this is how the potential drop is measured by the amplifier. So when the electron reaches the anode, what happens? So sudden drop in potential. So when the huge number of electrons attaches with the filament, a sudden drop in potential happens. So this sudden drop of potential is measured by the amplifier, this amplifier. So the potential drop, it is amplified by the amplifier. So this would be the amplifier. I have done it just like this to make you easy to understand, and measured in terms of voltage. Remember, it is then converted to voltage terminology and measured. So this potential drop is measured in terms of voltage, and the alpha particles possesses, each alpha particle possesses 5 mega electron volt. And so now we got the total voltage. So now we got the total voltage of all the alpha particles. So now we can determine the number of alpha particles from the total voltage. How? So the total voltage, if it be x volts, x something kilovolt or something like this, like x volt, and if we divide it with the each alpha particle energy, that is a 5 mega electron volt, then we'll get the number of alpha particles that is going inside this Geiger-Müller counter chamber. So from this we can determine the number of alpha particles entering this chamber, and we can measure the radiation that is caused by the alpha particles in terms of voltage. So what happened from the beginning, that alpha particle releases this Gaussian ion which causes the ionization of the gaseous ions, liberating cation and negative electrons, and this causes an electric field inside this chamber, and the negative goes towards the anode, positive anode, and by the excitation of number of electrons in a chain-wise manner after the primary ionization, then what happens, secondary ionization happens, and then tertiary, like this, go on, and many electrons reach this anode filament, and the positive cation goes to the cathode, and this change in potential is measured by the amplifier in terms of voltage. And this is how the whole process works. So there is some questions and doubts regarding the dead time. The dead time, what is the dead time actually? So it is a disadvantage. How? The potential difference between the anode and cathode at some point becomes zero, because the positive cation goes to the negative cathode and the negative electron goes to the positive anode filament. So when the negative interacts with the positive, that is the negative plus positive, results into the neutralization process. So it becomes neutral. So after becoming neutral, so there is a change in potential. So this both neutral thing happens in both the cathode and anode, because there is cation reaching the cathode and negative reaching the anode. And at a point, the difference between the potential becomes zero. So the difference between the potential becomes zero, because both are getting neutralized by a opposite charge. So there is, at this point, the potential becomes zero. And at this stage, there will be no working of this Geiger-Müller counter. So at that moment, the counter cannot determine any incoming radiations by alpha or beta particle, because the potential difference has become zero, and no more potential drop can be recorded. And if we see that there is one another disadvantage, that it cannot determine the gamma particle, gamma rays. It cannot determine the gamma rays incoming inside the Geiger-Müller chamber. So there are more disadvantages regarding this Geiger-Müller counter. So these are the disadvantages. I hope you like this video. So please give a like and do share this with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for more pharmaceutical videos coming up. Bye.